the open page here. Oh, here we go. What are we looking at here? Beat me up, Scotty. Who said that? Stand up. He said it.
All of them said it?
Okay, I just wanted to know, but I want you to stand up anyway. Okay. Bring your jacket with you. Form and function. What's this the shape of? Jacket. What's this function? What does it do? Keeps him warm. Can someone come up and write jacket up here? And then write the word warm. We're just writing these words down. Later on, we'll be able to look at these and generate ideas. Okay? Now, this is a jacket. It's in the shape, the form of a jacket. I want you to hold it up. Now, if you were in outer space with these guys leading up, what else could that be? Put it on. A what? Gear on here. Okay? A space jacket. And what does a space jacket do?
Help make you feel
cool. Stand up so everyone can hear you. Yes. Okay, no, come on, no, really, seriously. Come on over here. When anyone's shy, believe me, I used to be just like this, very shy. Okay? Look at me now. Can't shut me up. Okay? We're here having fun. Okay? We're amongst friends. This is a brainstorming, generating ideas. It's a fun project. So we don't have to worry about being shy, or going to the blackboard or to the paper and writing about something. What did you say? Okay, write that down there. Again, this is an informal presentation. We don't have to worry about spelling words correctly. We're just jotting ideas down so that we can turn them into futuristic artifacts, new ideas. We can take these shapes and forms, take this book, randomly turn to any page. He turns to a blank page. Okay, what do we have here? The enterprise. Now, how are we going to take this enterprise, as we said before, and make it actually fly? Huh? That's not a bad idea. Stand up. Come on, stand up. What did you say? Say it loud. Okay, he was being funny. That's another way to generate ideas. He said, chuck it up in the air. He's being a smart one. Okay?
What?
He said, throw it in the air. But, you know, if you're on the moon and you take something and you throw it, is it going to fall like it does to Earth? Or what'll happen? It'll keep going. Why? Stand up. Sit down. What? Stand up. Why would it keep going in outer space and not here on Earth? You threw something. You threw a ball in outer space. What happened? Stand up. Can I borrow this? This is a form. It's in the shape of a pamphlet. It has pages. Its function, keep yours rolled up, please. Its function is to read and transfer information. Brainstorming. When it's rolled up like these here, it could be a telescope. Sit down. It could be a hello. Anyone out there? Hello. What's that? A megaphone? Okay. What else could it be? Okay, what staying function? How about a pump? Pour water in it? So we changed the form and got a different function out of the piece of paper. Let's sit down.
Okay, people, this is now break time. We'll go straight to break. Can you look at the sheets before we go away? In room 102, Mr. Hillier. Remember, 102. Who doesn't know where that is? No one. Good. Hey. Thank you. Miss Evans, room 221 upstairs.
Start taking it apart and save all the pieces. Don't throw anything away. Remember, junk is a terrible thing to waste.
Okay, these will come all the way out. Take the side panels off.
Don't worry about these. There's some screws underneath in the bottom. Take those apart. How would I put these in?
We're looking for some rubbish that there's motors and light bulbs and things like that we can make our models.
Oh, right, so you just do a little research, taking bits and pieces out.
Looking for some.
Okay.
Which piece of junk to pee, take apart? And now that you have your idea on paper, you can start getting little pieces from the junk pile. So go grab one, like a radio or an old VCR or anything. If it's too heavy, you can help someone carry it over. Leave your paper here. Go select some junk and bring it back. There are tools over there on the table.
Reggie's gonna ask you what's
she doing?
Trying to get out. It's a year-man project about energy, and we're designing and building models which are powered by electricity and any other form of energy that you can get.
And Vince came from New York, Chicago.
So that's why you gather around all the scrap and...
Yep.
Right. How long do you reckon you have something live going here? Something properly done? What, where?
6-7 weeks.
Take you that long? Alright. Yeah. Right. Now, what exactly are you not doing? Right. Explain in detail.
We're doing
How long do you reckon it would take you for something for the project to be finished?
That's all mad, right? This is the creation. Careful. This is a what sort of circuit? A
parallel
circuit. What have we got in here? What sort of components? That is a... Come and concentrate. That's a motor, that one. That's an LED, and that's a
LED.
Okay. Just tell us when that's enough. Four yellow LEDs, and we also need one of those other LEDs, the one that flashes for us with a mark on it. Hang on a second, please. Next, we need two motors in each one, and we need 10 wires.
Everything you're working with right now, another part of this project, you'll be taking junk apart. Old radios, TVs, VCRs. You may have some old things at home. Don't take your mom, your dad, television apart at home. But here in the art department, we're going to have some things we're going to give you. When you take them apart, you're going to find LEDs. You're going to find some of these small motors. Those you'll be able to take home and experiment with or incorporate into your project. Okay.
So you're going to be using those to make your sculptures and things, all right? Now you learn how to work, you can put them in your sculptures. All right, now let's make sure all your trays are sorted, okay?
Terrible thing to waste. Good motto. So a lot of good reading.
What's that mean?
Was it controlled by
the brain? Well, the brain makes the electrical impulses.
Was it actually controlled by the
brain? Yes.
In real life?
Yes. Mm-hmm. It's not that hard. It's very easy. Simple electronics. You can learn about here in class. If you want to work on a project like that, we can do that. You ever see pictures of people in the hospital and they have all these wires to the head and then they see the needles move? It's an electroencephalograph, EEG. And what it's doing is picking up the energy from the brain and turning it into electrical and mechanical movements. The brain puts out a pulse. It's about 5 microvolts. Very, very small volts. But with the right type of equipment, you can measure it and pick up the voltage. It's like, it's very similar to this. You ever walk in a carpet in the wintertime and touch a doorknob, see a spark? It's energy leaving the body. Yeah, like on the astroturf, exactly. Well, the brain produces an electrical impulse, chemicals fire in the brain. You have brain cells. The ends up in the beginning, endites and dendrites. There's a little space in the middle called a synapse area. Then you have a liquid called neurotransmitters. That's something that makes electricity flow. Okay? A neurotransmitter would be like acetylcholine. That's just the name of one of the neurotransmitters. So when you're thinking, each brain cell, actually when you think, move, when you stand there, it's producing electricity which is fed through the nervous system to the muscles. So if I had like an antenna for a TV, beep, 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 if I had an antenna hooked on your head, then I could pick up that energy coming from your head. You too. Well, no, maybe there's no brain there. Each of us, all of us, produce electrical impulses. And you can learn to control those impulses so you can make it. There's 4 types of brain waves: alpha, beta, data, theta. And what they, that's just different frequencies. It's like when you turn to BBC One, BBC Two, Radio 1, Radio 2, Radio 4, well, it's different signals. And the brain produces many different types of signals, of which there are 4 basic signals. And you can actually learn how to control them. And when you control by thinking the brain waves, you can hook it up to a machine. So if you think one way, then the machine will run, or it'll stop. Okay, teacher's talking. Stretches it that way. But when you take the physical parts that they're going to be working with, and they're actually touching it and feeling it, then you can explain the principles, and it just triggers. And all of a sudden, it just picks up, and they start learning. It's called kid-driven. Hand on, mind on. You know, your minds and hands working together. Because, you know, when you were in class, when I was in class, if you just sat and read a book, for me, it was dull and boring. Mm-hmm. But as soon as I got to, like, science lab and started taking things apart, or working with the chemistry sets or the physics, it was fun.
From actual day one, you've been inventing.
Well, I mean, as a kid, and we all know, most kids take stuff apart. Reassemble it and that sort of thing. But as an engineer, it's just a little more sophisticated. Then you add art to it, because art is science. And that's why we say bridging the gap between art and science, because art indeed allows the right brain, the visual, to think, okay, if I could make this, what might it look like? That's the shape, okay, or the form. And then the left brain, the analytical thinking, allows us to figure out how, you know, what's driven on the board there. That's the analytical, that's the left brain. Figuring out how it works. That's the function. The form is when the kids were taking the motors and the LEDs and the clips and just sort of experimenting to see how the motors turn in one direction. If you have a DC hooked up, positive, negative, and you reverse the polarity, it turns the motor. All those things become so real and so tangible that when they do pick up the books, instead of trying to figure out, now, geez, in my mind, I'm seeing this wire on the page, and what does that mean if I do this or that? But when they're actually doing it, you actually, as you guys are working here, you can see the faces. You just watch the faces of the kids when they start taking things apart. And then you yourself, like you say, when you get home, it's a habit. Do you guys have kids at home? Not yet. Well, you do. You know how sometimes parents will say, don't take anything apart. Don't destroy it. Well, let them take it apart. Let them get every little piece out. And then, challenge them to reassemble it, not necessarily as it was, but into something else. And that's how discovery, that's where ideas come from.
We're going to ask you just basic questions, right? And then just fire away, right? You not comfortable?
Yeah.
All right. I'm going to start with you first, right? What do you mostly enjoy from I know you started the project today, but what do you enjoy already from the project?
Science and the art part, the sort of design thing.
What about you, Trisha?
I like the exhibition. Did all the great design sculptures, so it's pretty good. Good to see all the things that you make.
Right, why are you like, looking to invent? Or you haven't thought of it yet?
Oh, we're going to be making a volcano.
Volcano?
Yeah, we're putting lights.
Are in the same group?
Putting lights in there.
So you've not got, have you not got the perfect jack, I should say, there?
No, not
start
yet.
Not yet. So how long do you reckon it would take you to make this volcano? Give some rough estimate.
2 weeks.
2 weeks. The last group said 2 months, so you lot seem much more confident.
Yeah, well, it's not that hard to do, is it?
Question. Any more questions? Wait a minute now.
I went in the exhibition.
Anything you want to think of?
I went in it.
Yeah, so you haven't been there?
No, I've been to it, yeah.
What do you think about the inventions that American does?
It's pretty good. I like the bubble one, when you turn the wheel around, produce the bubbles. That's
pretty good. Do you reckon soon you will be inventing things in a week? Like that, out of jack?
Hopefully.
Do you reckon it's going to stay with you continuously? I mean, you can have like old radios, old TVs. Yeah. I think you're going to be at home and say to yourself, right, I'm going to try something here. Reckon you do that?
Mama
let me. So you plan to let the lava come out of the volcano?
We're not going to have any lava, we're just going to have the lighting in the middle.
And there's going to be, we can get loads of lights going down the side of the volcano and just cover it in red.
And have film and steam coming out of it as well.
Right, so it's going to have, I shall say, the special effects.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, Thomas and Trisha.
Interesting, like, you just go around seeing things move and scenery, it looks good.
What do you enjoy?
Well, I enjoy looking at sculptures and the arts really interesting. Good.
Right. So how long would you reckon it would take you to invent something out of junk?
Long. Long.
Give me an estimate, a month and a half?
More than that, about 3 months.
Right. How long reckon it would take you?
I concentrate, it would take me about 2.5 months.
I reckon that you're capable to gather your own junk and come here and just do something and get something working.
Yeah, it looks interesting still, but I can't wait to finish it because I want to say it.
What are you making?
I don't even know yet. I don't even know. Because it does some design and science, but I'm not sure yet because we haven't got the junk yet to start making it, so I'm not sure.
What would you like to make?
A spaceship.
Spaceship.
What would you like to make for now?
Something big and interesting.
Like a Starship Enterprise.
Yeah.
Okay.
First things first, please. Now, I don't normally teach year 9, but I don't want to spend time talking about being respectful to one another and being cooperative and working in the lesson, alright? Don't want to do any of that business. We're going to go straight into the work that we want to do and try and discover certain things. Now, things like totes and bags I'm really particular about, mainly because they can be dangerous in the lab, alright? So totes really should be over in the far corner, bags tucked right underneath. Can you get the energy booklets out and a writing implement of some sort? Please put your mitt down. What's our energy source? Food, exactly. The energy source for the stuff we're going to do today, where's that coming from? Electricity. In front of your tables, Devon, in front of your tables, can you see where the source of electricity is going to come from? Where? Tell me. Do you know what that's called? Anyone? What's that thing called in front of you, that little box?
What is it? DC box.
DC box or a power pack, okay? Now, DC box or a power pack. Now that's going to be supplying your electricity for you. Most of them have got 2 sets of wires. You need to have a set of those two wires. Try and make sure that the two sets of wires... Now, let me see. Can you look over this direction, people? Now, they've got one set of wires like that. Agreed.